Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And we are looking at some of the top prospects in our organization that already have reached the MLB level. So first, let's look at Brian Anderson. So Brian Anderson is kind of struggling at this point. Hitting 219, 187. If you look at his attributes, he is improving, but it just hasn't translated to the field of play. And if you look at him, he's hit 8 home runs already, 25 RBIs. But his on-base percentage is only 254, something to be desired there. He's got 48 strikeouts on the season already. So he definitely has to improve there. And he's a guy that, you know, he needs to step it up a little bit because Martin Prado is doing his thing at third base. And he's actually moved around quite a bit. I put him in right field, put him at second base. But I'm actually going to put Brian Anderson on the bench in the next coming games because I want to give Johnny Giovitella his shot, because Johnny Giovitella has just been killing it, hitting 325, and I think he deserves it. He might be one of those guys that's just a redemption story, maybe a guy that never all of a sudden, you know, wasn't really a great player overall, was just average, but now he's all of a sudden starting to sprout towards the end of his career. We've seen a lot of guys like that, like Jose Bautista did the same thing. Jose Abreu is a late bloomer. All these guys, you know, there's a lot of guys that just come up in the major leagues and just blossom towards, you know, the end of their career. Not saying that Jose Abreu is toward the end of his career, but he's definitely been a late bloomer. I think he was a 27-year-old rookie. But let's look at a couple other guys. Lewis Brinson. Now, if we look at his real-life stats, in real life, he's only hitting 131 in 61 at-bats so far this season in real life. And if you look at him here, he's hitting 205 at AAA. So he is struggling at AAA as well as hitting 214 at the MLB level with me. So I don't know. Is it a chance that he can just be a bust? I mean, because he hasn't done great at the MLB level in real life. Hasn't done great in his game. He hit 106 with the Brewers last year. It just might turn out that he might be a bust. I'm definitely not going to give up on him, but it's something to keep your eye on. You never know. I mean, it just might not work out with Lewis Brinson. And it is early, so I'm not giving up on him. But another guy, the opposite. I mean, the tale of two prospects here. This is exactly what you want to see in a prospect. Jose Urena, he started out this season 3-7, so we sent him down. He actually walked two more guys and he struck out. 1.48 whip, so we sent him down to AAA to get some work, and look what he's done. I mean, just an absolute beast at AAA. Now he's on a hot streak, 5-0, 25 strikeouts, 14 walks, 0.43 ERA, and 0.94 whip. I mean, if anybody has deserved a call-up back to the majors, it's him, and he's getting it. He's getting it right now. So let's move him up to the major leagues, and we got to move somebody down. So who I'm thinking right now, Adam Conley has just been struggling out of the pen. But if you look at him, he has a 1.40 whip, but his ERA is just 4.53, which is pretty high. So you know what? I'm going to spare him a little bit. I'm going to keep him at the MLB level. We're probably going to move down. Jumbo Diaz is kind of hit and miss. He's kind of hit and miss. I mean, some games he's on, some games he's off. But you know what? I'm going to have to think about this a little bit because, you know, we do need all the arms in the pen we can get. So I am actually thinking about moving down Adam Conley. He is 3-1. He's doing okay, not great. You know, Despaigne is doing good. I can't move him down. James Shields is actually, he's our strikeout leader right now. 90 strikeouts. He's doing really good. Wei Yin Chen as well. So Trevor Cahill could be the odd man out. I don't know if I have any options on him. So he has 2 out of 3 options left. You know, Trevor Cahill just might get moved down here. He's kind of the odd man out here. It's between him and Adam Conley. And Adam Conley, I mean, he's doing okay. I don't want to say he's doing bad, but he just is underwhelming a little bit. Just a little bit underwhelming, but I do need another left-hander in the rotation. So it might be him, Trevor Cahill, going down, even though we just signed him. We did only need him for depth, really. So we're just going to move him down, use one of his minor league options. So there he goes down to AAA. Jose Urena gets his first start, and we're actually going up against a team that is doing pretty bad. I can't lie, they're doing pretty bad. It's the Tampa Bay Rays, and we are actually 5 games under 500. I mean, we are competing And if you look at the standings here, we are not far off, not from the division, but from the wild card. We are 6 games back from the wild card. We never expected to be this close. And maybe we can string together a couple wins. I'm not saying I'm going to try to make a move to win now, but if we do end up winning now and with this young team and this growing organization with the growing farm system, I mean, I would take it. I'll take it. So we're going up against Ryan Yarbrough, who isn't really doing that great this year. He's 1-9. So the perfect game for Jose Arena to start in this one. And we're at home. So let's hop into the action. Let's go. So Jose Urena back on the mound for the Marlins, and look at his strikeout to walk ratio. It was pretty bad when he was at the MLB level, but now he's got his feet up under him now, getting going in this game. Now he's back at the MLB level, striking out two guys early in the first inning, this time on a drop third strike. Realmuto throws out the runner on that one. So here we're facing Ryan Yarbrough, and he's not having a great year, but he does have a good strikeout-to-walk ratio. So early on in the second inning, here's Martin Prado getting it going with a shot to left field on the 0-2 count. So now we have a guy on first with Johnny Giovitella coming to the plate, and he comes through, gets a hit up the middle, and that's going to be a guy on guys on first and second. With one out, Leury Garcia coming to the plate, and he hits a slow ground ball to the second baseman, but he can't handle it. So Leury Garcia loads up the bases, and that's going to bring the pitcher, Jose Urena, to the plate. And on a 1-2 count, he's going to get a changeup on the outside part of the plate, and he's going to swing and miss. So Starlin Castro comes up with two outs, and he just cannot come through. Pops it up in the infield, and Tampa Bay is going to get away of this inning, and no runs surrendered. So now we're on to the top of the third here, and Urena is just rolling here. I mean, he's doing a pretty good job in his first game back. Ends up throwing only 4 innings of work, but looks pretty impressive. He has 5 strikeouts in his outing back in the MLB level. So now we're just trying to get some offense going. Bottom of the third, we can't get anything going. Bottom of the fifth, we can't get anything going. I mean, our bats are just not alive this game. It seems like Tampa Bay's kind of got our number at the plate. So now we're on to the bottom of the ninth inning. Justin Bour, probably our best hitter for average this season, strikes out, but look at the throw by the catcher, throwing the first baseman off the bag. So now we got a guy on first with one out with JT Realmuto coming up to the plate, 1-for-3 up to this point. Getting a 3-2 count over the middle, and he's going to strike out with that late swing. So now it's going to be 2 outs here in the ninth inning, and Martin Prado is going to pop up to the catcher, and this one is going to extra innings. So now on to the extra frames. Leury Garcia here in the bottom of the 10th inning, 1-2 count getting going. He's going to smack one to the left fielder, and that's going to be down for a hit. So now Leury Garcia's got some speed, so maybe we can bunt him over here, and that's exactly what we do on this play. The pitcher, Drew Steckenrider, does bunt him over, so now we got a guy on second with Starlin Castro coming to the plate. He could be a hero, but look at the manager of the Rays walks him here. So now we got a guy on first and second with Aquino coming up. Over fourth to this point, he's kind of been cooling off a little bit. But with a guy on first and second, he hits one, but that's right to the second baseman. So they're going to get out of this inning. And now we're on to later in the frames. JT Realmuto comes to the plate. Bottom of the 14th inning, he hits one hard up the middle on a 2-1 count, and he's going to start this inning off with the hit. So now Martin Prado comes up. Remember, he's been doing really well the last month or so, and he's going to get walked. So now we got guys on first and second with Johnny Giovitella, the surprise of this season, coming up to the plate, and he's going to hit a line shot up the middle, and JT Realmuto's got that speed, so he's coming around to score. And I mean, what a season Johnny Giovitella's having. He is just killing it for us at 30 years of age. I think he just might be a gem that we found. I mean, he was kind of going to be buried on our bench at the beginning of the season, but he's definitely showing us some things, especially with his showing at AAA. He was doing really good at AAA, so we eventually moved him up. So now we're moving on to the third game of this series, facing Chris Archer, and
The Tampa Bay Rays did lose the second game, so now we're on to this next game in the series. And Johnny Giavitella, he's back up to the plate, and he's been hot lately, but he gets walked this time by Chris Archer. And Chris Archer is probably their biggest trade chip, and Tampa Bay is probably in full-on tank mode. They are, I mean, their record is 29-57, so they're not doing well at all. So they're pretty much selling just like we are at the trade deadline. But we are only, we're close to 500, so we might not be completely selling. We might be buying a little bit at the trade deadline, but we're coming up to the All-Star break, so we'll see. So back to the action. Brian Holiday coming up, and this game I pretty much gave a lot of starters days off because they were all gassed, and it was versus a weaker Tampa Bay team, so I said, why not just let them sit this game? So now look at this, man. Getting out of the jam is the Tampa Bay Rays, and Chris Archer, I mean, he is a wizard on the mound. He was pretty hard to hit in this game, but here comes Carlos Gomez up to bat in the fifth inning, grounding out to Giavitella. But Hecavarria comes to the plate, the former Marlin, and Wei-Yin Chen on the mound, getting a big hit as Hecavarria, and that one is going to be off the wall in center field. And Leury Garcia is actually playing center field this game, and he's going to come up throwing, but not before a triple for Hecavarria. So now a guy on third, one out with the next hitter coming up to bat. 2-1 count. Going to get a nice pitch to hit. Wei-Yin Chen's going to leave it over the middle of the plate, and that one is going to be hit down the line, but not before Tampa Bay comes in to score for their first run of the game. So Ref Snyder does come through with a double that time. But now with two outs, grounder to third base, and we do tag the runner on that one. So now Miguel Rojas comes up here in the eighth inning, and down by one run, here he is finally getting going in this series. I mean, he hasn't really been a guy that's really been shown on many videos because he hasn't been doing too much. Remember, he was on the DL for most of the season, so now he's finally back getting to start this game. But Starlin Castro comes up next. He gets hit with the pitch, but Leury Garcia comes up playing a little small ball this time, bunting the runners over to second and third. So now we got guys on second and third, one out, with Johnny Giavitella, Mr. Reliable up to this point, comes to the plate on a 1-2 count. Is going to hit this one to right field. Remember last time, the right fielder threw out the runner. This time, we're tagging up, and that throw is a little offline, and Miguel Rojas does come in to score, so that's going to tie this game up in the eighth inning. So here's Kittredge coming out of the bullpen, and Domingo Santana comes up to the plate. Guy on second, two outs, but he's going to strike out at a pitch outside and low, and that's going to be a strikeout for Santana. So now on to the ninth inning. Two outs here. Martin Prado comes to the plate showing some two-out bats here late in this game. So now Brian Anderson, a guy that got the start in this game but has been kind of cold this season, 3-2 count, two outs, and he drives one to right field. That's a liner down the line, and Martin Prado is on his horse heading home, and he's going to slide in. So back to back walk-off wins in this episode versus Tampa Bay, and that is going to be a good sign for Brian Anderson, a good for him, because I do want to evaluate him some more. He is a potential. People forget that he's a potential, so he's maybe even, you know, if he shows that he may be a bust, he might be a guy that we might try to move as well. We don't know. But I definitely want to evaluate him some more. And with Martin Prado getting traded more than likely before the deadline, Brian Anderson is going to get a lot of playing time at third base. So we have a lot of time to evaluate the type of player he is. So I hope he has more games like this where he shows up when it matters most. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. We'll be back for the next episode. We're getting closer to the All-Star game, so you don't want to miss any action. Let's get it.